Welcome, design and construction professionals. From Construction Scrum, Chapter 9, Using the Scrum Guide to Make Your Playbook. It's time to begin using what we know. If you have never sprinted before, don't worry. Let's go slow together to go fast. The Scrum Board is just one way to make things visible. A new Scrum Master will use what they know from the Scrum Guide and a Scrum Board to make work visible. Remember, only do one thing at a time. Listen to understand. I highly recommend you follow along using the 2020 Scrum Guide, published on November 2020. It's free and available in over 30 languages online. The following excerpts read from the guide will include my commentary as I have adapted it with design and construction professionals using Scrum in their daily work. The purpose of the guide, we, Jeff Sutherland and Ken Schwaber, developed Scrum in the early 1990s. We wrote this version of the first Scrum Guide in 2010 to help people worldwide understand Scrum. We have evolved the guide since then through small, functional updates. Together, we stand behind it. The Scrum Guide contains the definitions of Scrum. Each element of the framework serves a specific purpose that is essential to the overall value and results realized with Scrum. Changing the core design or ideas of Scrum, leaving out elements, or not following the rules of Scrum covers up problems and limits the benefits of Scrum, potentially even rendering it useless. Side note, if you're using sticky notes on a board with columns labeled to do, doing, and done, that's not enough to be Scrum. That's not enough even to be considered Kanban. All right, back to the guide. We follow the growing use of Scrum within an ever-growing complex world. We are humbled to see Scrum being adopted in many domains, holding essentially complex work beyond software product development, where Scrum has its roots. As Scrum's use spreads, developers, researchers, analysts, scientists, and other specialists do the work. We use the word developers in Scrum not to exclude, but to simplify. If you get value from Scrum, consider yourself included. Side note, the usage of Scrum has spread far beyond hardware, software, and information technology, IT. It is also being used by students, educators, bankers, business startups, Fortune 500 companies, and design and construction professionals around the globe. I will be using project team or team member instead of the word developers. Back to the guide. As Scrum is being used, patterns, processes, and insights that fit the Scrum framework as described in this document may be found, applied, and devised. Their description is beyond the purpose of the Scrum Guide because they are context sensitive and differ widely between Scrum uses. Such tactics for using within the Scrum framework vary widely and are described elsewhere. Side note, this book includes many examples, and there are even more applications described on my podcast, The EBFC Show, the easier, better for construction podcast. How Scrum is used by teams even inside the same project can differ widely, since tactics for using the Scrum framework will vary based on the team's work capabilities and Scrum experiences. Back to the guide. Scrum definition. Scrum is a lightweight framework that helps teams and organizations generate value through adaptive solutions for complex problems. Scrum definition. Scrum is a lightweight framework that helps teams and organizations generate value through adaptive solutions for complex problems. Side note, according to Jeff, Scrum provides the minimum sized amount of bureaucracy to allow people to work together to deliver owner value. Back to the guide. In a nutshell, Scrum requires a Scrum Master to foster an environment where 1. A product owner orders the work for a complex problem into a product backlog. 2. The Scrum team turns a selection of the work into an increment of value during a sprint. 3. The Scrum team and its stakeholders inspect the results and adjust for the next sprint. 4. Repeat. Side note. The product owner is a functional title. It is for the person responsible for what the Scrum team delivers. In construction, it is most often the person on the team that can allocate resources and most often interfaces with the project owner and sets priorities to support meeting the owner's needs and expectations. An increment of value is exactly equivalent to installed work in place for the construction phase or completed design drawings, details, calculations for the pre-construction phase. Back to the guide. Scrum is simple. Try it as is and determine if its philosophy, theory, and structure help to achieve goals and create value. The Scrum framework is purposefully incomplete. only defining the parts required to implement Scrum theory. Scrum is built upon by the collective intelligence of the people using it. Rather than provide people with detailed instructions, the rules of Scrum guide their relationships and interactions. Side note, just try it. I wasn't perfect when I started, but I was patient and disciplined. Today, I've helped thousands of teams get started for themselves while delivering value daily for my partners. Back to the guide. Various processes, techniques, and methods can be employed within the framework. Scrum wraps around existing practices or renders them unnecessary. Scrum makes visible the relative efficacy of current management, environment, and work techniques so that improvements can be made. Side note, Scrum is a framework that can support and enable many types of project team organizations and lean tools, like the Last Planner system of production controls. Project processes like onboarding, inspections, planning and scheduling, change orders, change management, and countless other applications. Back to the guide. Scrum theory. Scrum is founded on empiricism and lean thinking. Side note, I have confirmed with dozens of experts across the globe, including people working at the Lean Enterprise Institute that were part of bringing the word lean into our vocabulary, and have confirmed it should not be capitalized. Just some fun lean trivia. Back to the guide. Empiricism asserts that knowledge comes from experience and making decisions based on what is observed. Lean thinking reduces waste and focuses on the essentials. Scrum employs an iterative, incremental approach to optimize predictability and to control risk. Scrum engages groups of people who collectively have all the skills and expertise to do the work and share or acquire such skills as needed. Side note, iteration is aligned with design thinking, continuous improvement, and Scrum is built upon the scientific method / cycle of PDCA. Plan, do, check, or study, act, or adjust, or abandon. Back to the guide. Scrum combines four formal events, meetings, for inspection, and adaptation within a containing event called the sprint. These events work because they implement the empirical Scrum pillars of transparency, inspection, and adaptation. Transparency. The emergent process and work must be visible to those performing the work as well as those receiving the work. With Scrum, important decisions are based on the perceived state of its three formal artifacts. Artifacts that have low transparency can lead to decisions that diminish value and increase risk. Side note, increasing transparency of the work done by project teams is one of the greatest improvement challenges that will nearly magically boost many key performance indicators from team health, safety, quality, schedule, and cost. Back to the guide. Transparency enables inspection. Inspection without transparency is misleading and wasteful. Side note, waste is a crime against humanity and should be minimized and eliminated. See Chapter 6 on Lean Construction Principles for how to recognize and banish waste. Back to the guide. Inspection. The Scrum artifacts, things that we can see and touch, and the progress toward agreed goals must be inspected frequently and diligently to detect potentially undesirable variances or problems. To help with inspection, Scrum provides cadence in the form of its five events. Inspection enables adaptation. Inspection without adaptation is considered pointless. Scrum events are designed to provoke change. Side note, design and construction projects are ripe with change. A typical project experiences changes in scope, variation in skill level among trades and management alike, changes in weather, coordination changes, etc. Back to the guide. Adaptation. If any aspects of a process deviate outside acceptable limits, or if the resulting product is unacceptable, the process being applied or the materials being produced must be adjusted. The adjustment must be made as soon as possible to minimize further deviation. Side note, variation is guaranteed to occur. Be open with yourself and your team about changes. Also, check your contracts. Back to the guide. Adaptation becomes more difficult when the people involved are not empowered or self-managing. A team is expected to adapt the moment it learns anything new through inspection. Side note, a new Scrum team doesn't start off empowered or self-managing. It may take more than a handful of sprints before the team begins to exhibit autonomous adaptation to changes. Back to the guide. Scrum values. Successful use of Scrum depends on people becoming more proficient in living the five Scrum values. Commitment, focus, openness, respect, and courage. Side note, failure to deeply understand and use these values will prevent you from actually doing real Scrum. Back to the guide. The Scrum team commits to achieving its goals and to supporting each other. Their primary focus is on the work of the sprint to make the best possible progress towards these goals. The Scrum team and its stakeholders are open about the work and the challenges. Scrum team members respect each other to be capable, independent people and are respected as such by the people with whom they work. The Scrum team members have the courage to do the right thing, to work on tough problems. Side note, these values lead to higher team performance and prevent typical team dysfunctions, such as low trust and low engagement. Back to the guide. These values give direction to the Scrum team with regard to their work, actions, and behavior. The decisions that are made, the steps taken, and the way Scrum is used should reinforce these values, not diminish or undermine them. The Scrum team members learn and explore the values as they work with the Scrum events and artifacts. When these values are embodied by the Scrum team and the people they work with, the empirical Scrum pillars of transparency, inspection, and adaptation come to life, building trust. Scrum team. The fundamental unit of Scrum is a small team of people, a Scrum team. The Scrum team consists of one Scrum Master, the team captain as commonly used in EduScrum, one product owner, not a project manager by default, and developers, team members, or project partners. Within a Scrum team, there are no sub-teams or hierarchies. It is a cohesive unit of professionals focused on one objective at a time, the product goal. Scrum teams are cross-functional, meaning the members have all the skills necessary to create value each sprint. They are also self-managing, meaning they internally decide who does what, when, and how. The Scrum team is small enough to remain nimble and large enough to complete significant work within a sprint. Typically, 10 or fewer people. In general, we have found that smaller teams communicate better and are more productive. Side note, teams of 4 to 6 are exponentially faster than teams of 10. Larger teams have more communication channels, and workflow stops when communication stops. Refer back to the good housekeeping pattern for examples of wasted energy and time when team members can't see the current progress of their work or don't have access to the needed information. Back to the guide. If Scrum teams become too large, they should consider reorganizing into multiple cohesive Scrum teams, each focused on the same product. Therefore, they should share the same product goal, product backlog, and product owner. The Scrum team is responsible for all product-related activities from stakeholder collaboration, verification, maintenance, operation, experimentation, research and development, and anything else that might be required. They are structured and empowered by the organization to manage their own work. Working in sprints at a sustainable pace improves the Scrum team's focus and consistency. The entire Scrum team is accountable for creating a valuable, useful increment every sprint. Side note, typical construction projects deliver incremental work in place each month and receive payments for the whole project based on progress to date. This is identically an increment of value delivery. Smaller increments allow for faster feedback and opportunities for greater value delivery. Back to the guide. Scrum defines three specific accountabilities within the Scrum team: the developers, the product owner, and the Scrum Master. Developers. Developers are the people in the Scrum team that are committed to creating any aspect of a usable increment for each sprint. Side note, I encourage Scrum team members to call themselves team members or project partners. Jeff Sutherland has repeatedly said in many of his talks that the functions of the role are more important than the role label. Back to the guide. The specific skills needed by the developers are often broad and will vary with the domain of work. However, the developers are always accountable for creating a plan for the sprint backlog, instilling a quality by adhering to a definition of done, adapting their plan each day toward the sprint goal, and holding each other accountable as professionals. Product owner. The product owner is accountable for maximizing the value of the product resulting from the work of the Scrum team. How this is done may vary widely across organizations, Scrum teams, and individuals. Side note, product owners in design and construction projects are the single person typically most responsible for the project's revenue flows, profit margins, and team assignments. A cross-functional design team may have the lead architect serve in the product owner role. An engineering team may have the engineering manager or director of engineering serve as the product owner. A small construction project team may have the project manager serve as the product owner. Larger construction projects may have a project executive or project director serve as the product owner. In the field, project superintendents or foremen often best fit the role for product owners. Back to the guide. The product owner is also accountable for effective product backlog management, which includes developing and explicitly communicating the product goal, creating and clearly communicating product backlog items, ordering product backlog items, and ensuring that the product backlog is transparent, visible, and understood. The product owner may do the above work or may delegate the responsibility to others. Regardless, the product owner remains accountable. For product owners to succeed, the entire organization must respect their decisions. These decisions are visible in the content and ordering of the product backlog and through the inspectable increment at the sprint review. The product owner is one person, not a committee. The product owner may represent the needs of many stakeholders in the product backlog. Those wanting to change the product backlog can do so by trying to convince the product owner. Side note, product owners very often also pull product backlog items, meaning that they work as part of the team. They are responsible for what the team delivers each sprint. Back to the guide. Scrum Master. The Scrum Master is accountable for establishing Scrum as defined in the Scrum Guide. They do this by helping everyone understand Scrum theory and practice, both within the Scrum team and the organization. The Scrum Master is accountable for the team's effectiveness. They do this by enabling the Scrum team to improve its practices within the Scrum framework. Scrum Masters are true leaders who serve the Scrum team and the larger organization. Side note, Scrum Masters very often also pull product backlog items, meaning that they work as part of the team. They are responsible for enabling the team to use Scrum and improve the team's performance each sprint. Back to the guide. The Scrum Master serves the Scrum team in several ways, including coaching team members in self-management and cross-functionality, helping the Scrum team focus on creating high-value increments that meet the definition of done, causing the removal of impediments, bottlenecks, constraints, issues, challenges to the Scrum team's progress, and ensuring that all Scrum events take place and are positive, productive, and kept within the time box. The Scrum Master serves the product owner in several ways, including helping find techniques for effective product goal definition and product backlog management, helping the Scrum team understand the need for clear and concise product backlog items, helping establish empirical product planning for a complex environment, and facilitating stakeholder collaboration as requested or needed. The Scrum Master serves the organization in several ways, including leading, training, and coaching the organization in its Scrum adoption, planning and advising Scrum implementation within the organization, helping employees and stakeholders understand and enact an empirical approach for complex work, and removing barriers between stakeholders and Scrum teams. Scrum events. The sprint. The sprint is a container for all other Scrum events. Each Scrum event in Scrum is a formal opportunity to inspect and adapt Scrum artifacts. These events are more specifically designed to enable the transparency required. Failure to operate any events as prescribed results in lost opportunities to inspect and adapt. Events are used in Scrum to create regularity and to minimize the need for meetings not defined in Scrum. Optimally, all events are held at the same time and place to reduce complexity. The sprint. Sprints are the heartbeat of Scrum, where ideas are turned into value. They are fixed-length events of 1 month or less to create consistency. A new sprint starts immediately after the conclusion of the previous sprint. Side note, general contractors often use one-week sprint durations. Pre-construction and estimating teams often use single-week sprint durations as well. Design teams typically use shorter duration sprints when design is emerging and shift to longer sprint durations when they enter into production design, or detail design, as it's sometimes known. Field teams composed of tradespeople often use single-week duration sprints. Once a team picks a duration, keep it for at least 3 sprints before deciding to experiment with another length. This will allow the team to inspect and adapt to shorter or longer sprint durations. The better practice is to maintain the same sprint duration for the entire span of the project's lifecycle. I have personally used single-week sprints successfully for years. My podcast team uses a two-week sprint cycle. New shows post every 2 weeks. I've seen large multi-$100 million construction teams successfully use four-week sprint cycles and later shift to weekly sprints as they learn to decrease the batch size of their work increments. It is quite counterintuitive, but smaller batch sizes deliver faster than larger batch sizes due to the longer wait times from the one phase of work to the next. Experiment to see what works best for your team. Back to the guide. All the work necessary to achieve the product goal, including sprint planning, daily scrums, sprint review, and sprint retrospective, happen within sprints. During the sprint, no changes are made that would endanger the sprint goal. Quality does not decrease. The product backlog is refined as needed, and scope may be clarified and renegotiated with the product owner as more is learned. Sprints enable predictability by ensuring inspection and adaptation of progress toward a product goal at least every calendar month. When a sprint's horizon is too long, the sprint goal may become invalid, complexity may arise, and risk may increase. Shorter sprints can be employed to generate more learning cycles and limit risk of cost and effort to a smaller time frame. Each sprint may be considered a short project. Various practices exist to forecast progress, like burndowns, burnups, or cumulative flows. While proven useful, these do not replace the importance of empiricism. In complex environments, what will happen is unknown. Side note, all phases of design and construction projects qualify as complex, since they consist of many different and interconnected parts. A team should focus on the sprint goal to deliver value first before expending energy on forecasting. Let the team get through at least three sprints before you can reasonably start to predict how fast they are going to deliver. Back to the guide. Only what has already happened may be used for forward-looking decision-making. A sprint could be canceled if the sprint goal becomes obsolete. Only the product owner has the authority to cancel the sprint. Side note, canceling sprints is not good for team morale, so weigh the decision carefully. Back to the guide. Sprint planning. Sprint planning initiates the sprint by laying out the work to be performed for the sprint. This resulting plan is created by the collaborative work of the entire Scrum team. The product owner ensures that attendees are prepared to discuss the most important product backlog items and how they map to the product goal. The Scrum team may also invite other people to attend sprint planning to provide advice. Examples may include facility personnel, doctors, nurses, students, faculty, and other design disciplines, trade partners, inspectors, etc. Sprint planning addresses the following topics. Topic 1. Why is this sprint valuable? The product owner proposes how the product, service, or combination of both could increase its value and utility in the current sprint. The whole Scrum team then collaborate to define a sprint goal that communicates why the sprint is valuable to the stakeholders. The sprint goal must be finalized prior to the end of sprint planning. Topic 2. What can be done this sprint? Through discussion with the product owner, the developers select items from the product backlog to include the current sprint. The Scrum team may refine these items during this process, which increases understanding and confidence. Selecting how much can be completed within a sprint may be challenging. However, the more the developers know about their past performance, their upcoming capacity, and their definition of done, the more confident they will be in their sprint forecasts. Topic 3. How will the chosen work get done? For each selected product backlog item, the developers plan the work necessary to create an increment that meets the definition of done. This is often done by decomposing product backlog items into smaller work items of 1 day or less. How this is done is at the sole discretion of the developers. No one else tells them how to turn product backlog items into increments of value. The sprint goal, the product backlog items selected for the sprint, plus the plan for delivering them are together referred to as the sprint backlog, also commonly known as the to-do list of work tasks. Sprint planning is time-boxed to a maximum of 8 hours for a one-month sprint. For shorter sprints, the event is usually shorter. Side note, several times during a given project of multiple years' duration, I've increased the sprint planning time and achieved greater output of value delivery. I often spend a few hours or more in sprint planning with new teams working on one-week sprints as they experience Scrum more. The planning time decreases to about 2 hours or less each sprint. Ben Franklin famously said, "If you fail to plan, you are planning to fail." Back to the guide. Daily Scrum. The purpose of the daily Scrum is to inspect progress towards the sprint goal and adapt the sprint backlog as necessary, adjusting the upcoming planned work. The developers can select whatever structure and techniques they want, as long as their daily Scrum focuses on progress towards the sprint goal and produces an actionable plan for the next day of work. This creates focus and improves self-management. The daily Scrum is a 15-minute event, meeting, daily stand-up, daily huddle for the developers of the Scrum team. To reduce complexity, it is held at the same time and place every working day of the sprint. If the product owner or Scrum Master are actively working on items in the sprint backlog, they participate as developers, with the meeting facilitated by the Scrum Master. Side note, more than 99.9% of Scrum teams have their product owners and Scrum Masters working on sprint backlog items. Better Scrum Masters start by facilitating the daily Scrum and quickly enable all team members to take turns and keep them engaging. Construction job site teams start or end the team's day with the daily Scrum. This purposeful meeting structure will facilitate more efficient communication, collaboration, and personal accountability. The following sections are better practice and based on decades of direct participation and observation. The who. The trades that put the work in the building. The trades put in the work that builds the building. When they see that the entire team is active in the daily Scrum, it fosters greater buy-in. Team members for construction often include foremen, assistant superintendents, general foremen, and superintendents. Meetings will be even more productive if the general contractor's project manager, assistant project manager, and project engineers attend. Their participation provides faster resolutions on constraints that may involve the input of the design team or owner. 15 minutes or less. The meeting is always 15 minutes or less. Period. Some teams use a phone timer to practice keeping it short and sweet. No distractions. Everyone participates with full engagement. Allowing participants to use their phones, tablets, or computers communicates the wrong message of mutual respect. Effective person-to-person communication is the focus, not browsing devices. Stand up. Remove the chairs from the meeting space or be at the team Scrum board with everyone standing. This drives engagement and focus. Set and keep the standard. Each team member completes the following statements. Yesterday I worked on, today I'm working on, with X crews and Y workers on site. My task constraints or needs are, I'm expecting these Z material deliveries at. These statements engage the field leaders running the work. Sharing these project updates increases collaboration and coordination with others. No problem solving. The meeting identifies problems, which end up in the parking lot, to be resolved with responsible parties after the meeting. Parking lots use whiteboards to capture issues as they arise so they are visible for everyone and keep the meeting flowing uninterrupted. Placing items in the parking lot means that a quick discussion follows the huddle with the affected people to discuss the issues or circumstances that did not require everyone's involvement. Daily Scrums improve communications, identify impediments, promote quick decision-making, and consistently eliminate the need for other meetings. If you are asking yourself where to begin with Scrum, the daily Scrum is often a great starting point that improves teamwork, increases capacity, and helps enable work to flow more effortlessly. Back to the guide. The daily Scrum is not the only time developers are allowed to adjust their plan. They often meet throughout the day for more detailed discussions about adapting or replanning the rest of the sprint's work. Side note, we are engaged in complex work. Replanning and negotiating changes to the work are normal and should be expected. If you aren't convinced, examine any waterfall, Gantt chart, critical path schedule to see how the initial project plan matched the final as-built project plan. Sprint review. The purpose of the sprint review is to inspect the outcome of the sprint and determine future adaptations. The Scrum team presents the results of their work to key stakeholders and progress towards the product goal is discussed. Side note, in design, this is often done as a meeting where stakeholders see completed portions of the design and give feedback. Better practice is for the team to record all the feedback and only ask clarifying questions, not engaging in defending the design or arguing. In construction, this is often done by inspecting the completed work in place, aka job walk, go and see, Gemba. Think of how teams review construction mockups for some inspiration. Back to the guide. The Scrum team and stakeholders review what was accomplished in the sprint and what has changed in their environment. Based on this information, attendees collaborate on what to do next. The product backlog may also be adjusted to meet new opportunities. The sprint review is a working session, and the Scrum team should avoid limiting it to a presentation. The sprint review is the second to last event of the sprint, and is time-boxed to a maximum of 4 hours for a one-month sprint. For shorter sprints, the event is usually shorter. Side note, the math works out to be about 60 minutes of review time for each week of a sprint. A two-week sprint would allocate a two-hour sprint review. Back to the guide. Sprint retrospective. The purpose of the sprint retrospective is to plan ways to increase quality and effectiveness. Side note, this meeting is only for the Scrum team. No outsiders, no stakeholders. It is a meeting for the team to reflect and find improvements to experiment with on the next sprint. Back to the guide. The Scrum team inspects how the last sprint went with regards to individuals, interactions, processes, tools, and their definition of done. Inspected elements often vary with the domain of work. Assumptions that led them astray are identified and their origins explored. The Scrum team discusses what went well during the sprint, what problems it encountered, and how those problems were or were not solved. Side note, experienced lean construction team members may even use A3 problem solving or value stream mapping tools to aid in problem solving. Back to the guide. The Scrum team identifies the most helpful changes to improve its effectiveness. The most impactful improvements are addressed as soon as possible. They may even be added to the sprint backlog for the next sprint. The sprint retrospective concludes the sprint. It is time-boxed to a maximum of 3 hours for a one-month sprint. For shorter sprints, the event is usually shorter. Side note, when a new Scrum team is starting out, plan for a 3-hour retro. You can always end a meeting early when you accomplish its purpose. Incredible innovation ideas typically emerge from these meetings that help teams accelerate with less effort in subsequent sprints. Back to the guide. Scrum artifacts. Scrum's artifacts represent work or value. They are designed to maximize transparency of key information. Thus, everyone inspecting them has the same basis for adaptation. Side note. Artifacts can also include objects we use during the sprints, such as scrum boards, drawing sheets, work in place, photos, spreadsheets, etc. Back to the guide. Each artifact contains a commitment to ensure it provides information that enhances transparency and focuses against which progress can be measured. For the product backlog, it is the product goal. Side note. The product goal answers the big why as to the purpose or intention of the complete construction project. Back to the guide. For the sprint backlog, it is the sprint goal. Side note. See the Scrum pattern section for more detail on the sprint goal pattern. Back to the guide. For the increment, it is the definition of done. Side note. In design, the product is a design or part of design, such as exterior elevation drawings or a systems line diagram. In construction, the product is the project or part of project, such as corridor drywall framing or incremental phase of work, such as backfilling a portion of the site. Back to the guide. These commitments exist to reinforce empiricism and the Scrum values for the Scrum team and their stakeholders. Product backlog. The product backlog is an emergent, ordered list of what the team needs to improve the product. It is the single source of work undertaken by the Scrum team. Product backlog items that can be done by the Scrum team within one sprint are deemed ready for selection in the sprint planning event. They usually acquire this degree of transparency after refining activities. Product backlog refinement is the act of breaking down and further defining product backlog items into smaller, more precise items. This is an ongoing activity to add details such as a description, order, and size. Attributes often vary with the domain of work. Side note, in design and construction, product backlog items could initially be something like this. Construction project team member onboarding, final building subcontractor contracting, architect and mechanical engineer design coordination. The team prepares these items for an upcoming sprint by using the story slicing techniques. Construction project team member onboarding. As a new construction project team member, I can access the latest training materials and best practices on-site and online so that I can use the best practices. New partners will start helping the team today. New project members should complete onboarding and initial employment documentation with the project administrator in a single workday. They will know why we are building this project. have all their questions answered, and meet key staff while touring the project office and site. Knowing who to ask for what and where to find how-to videos and procedures. Final building subcontractor contracting. As a construction team project manager, I want the most qualified and best priced final building cleaning contract to turn over an immaculate building to the owner at occupancy. Confirm budgeted contract value, schedule, and start date. Contract department and project director approval before draft terms are issued to the potential subcontractor. The approved contract is signed, filed, and contacts are scheduled for the first installation meeting. Architect and mechanical engineer design coordination. As the lead project architect, I want to coordinate floor plans with mechanical room shafts and structural elements to minimize walking distances for healthcare workers while maximizing line of sight for charge nurses towards patient rooms. Resolve all interdisciplinary conflicts. No open clouded comments remain on drawing sheets. Floor plans are conflict-free, all notes resolved by priority floor, level 1 to level 4 before the next scheduled milestone date. Back to the guide. The developers who will be doing the work are responsible for the sizing. The product owner may influence the developers by helping them understand and select trade-offs. Commitment. Product goal. The product goal describes a future state of the product which can serve as a target for the Scrum team to plan against. The product goal is in the product backlog. The rest of the product backlog emerges to define what will fulfill the product goal. A product is a vehicle to deliver value. It has a clear boundary, known stakeholders, well-defined users or customers. A product could be a service, a physical product, or something more abstract. Side note, in the Scrum Guide, product means product or service, or combination of both. Back to the guide. The product goal is the long-term objective for the Scrum team. They must fulfill or abandon one objective before taking on the next. Sprint backlog, to-do list of tasks. The sprint backlog is composed of the sprint goal, why, the set of product backlog items selected for the sprint, what, as well as an actionable plan for delivering the increment, how. Side note, use caution. Most typically, I see new teams and Scrum practitioners, me included, take on too many tasks into their first sprint. You and the team can always pull in more tasks from the top of the prioritized product backlog. Back to the guide. The sprint backlog is a plan by and for the developers. It is a highly visible, real-time picture of the work that the developers plan to accomplish during the sprint in order to achieve the sprint goal. Consequently, the sprint backlog is updated throughout the sprint as more is learned. It should have enough detail that they can inspect their progress in the daily scrum. Side note, well-understood work typically has historical data, or a budget of time, effort, and cost to accomplish the task. Use your judgment and experience of the team to make a realistic plan that will allow for smooth work progress to flow towards completion. Back to the guide. Commitment. Sprint goal. The sprint goal is the single objective for the sprint. Although the sprint goal is a commitment by the developers, it provides flexibility in terms of the exact work needed to achieve it. The sprint goal also creates coherence and focus, encouraging the Scrum team to work together rather than on separate initiatives. Side note, refer to the Scrum Patterns sprint goal for more details of why and how this impacts the team and aids in planning and replanning of the work. Back to the guide. The sprint goal is created during the sprint planning event and then added to the sprint backlog. As the developers work during the sprint, they keep the sprint goal in mind. If the work turns out to be different than expected, they collaborate with the product owner to negotiate the scope of the sprint backlog within the sprint without affecting the sprint goal. Increment. An increment is a concrete stepping stone toward the product goal. Each increment is additive to all prior increments and thoroughly verified, ensuring that all increments work together. In order to provide value, the increment must be usable. Side note. Just as completing project milestones get the team closer to final project delivery, so are increments of work in Scrum. Back to the guide. Multiple increments may be created within a sprint. The sum of the increments is presented at the sprint review, thus supporting empiricism. However, an increment may be delivered to stakeholders prior to the end of the sprint. The sprint review should never be considered as a gate to releasing value. Work cannot be considered part of an increment unless it meets the definition of done. Side note, the Scrum team uses the sprint goal to include and exclude what is part of the current increment. It's a work filter. Back to the guide. Commitment. Definition of done. The definition of done is a formal description of the state of increment where it meets the quality measures required for the product. The moment a product backlog item meets the definition of done, an increment is born. Side note, done means the customer can beneficially use the work as intended, or the next partner in the value stream can add their work to the project. Back to the guide. The definition of done creates transparency by providing everyone a shared understanding of what work was completed as part of the increment. If a product backlog item does not meet the definition of done, it cannot be released or even presented at the sprint review. Instead, it returns to the product backlog for future consideration. If the definition of done for an increment is part of the standards of the organization, all Scrum teams must follow it as a minimum. If it is not an organizational standard, the Scrum team must create a definition of done appropriate for the product. Side note, most design and construction professionals know what level of quality and completeness is required for subsequent handoffs in the value stream. Don't guess what is required for a given increment. Ask questions and find out during sprint planning. Back to the guide. The developers are required to conform to the definition of done. If there are multiple Scrum teams working together on a product, they must mutually define and comply with the same definition of done. End note. Scrum is free and offered in this guide. The Scrum framework, as outlined herein, is immutable. While implementing only parts of Scrum is possible, the result is not Scrum. Scrum exists only in its entirety and functions well as a container for other techniques, methodologies, and practices. Side note, I personally use the Scrum framework when using the Last Planner system of production controls. That is a pull system that is a collaborative, commitment-based planning system that integrates should, can, will, did, and learn conversations to make more reliable promises and project delivery. Acknowledgements. People. Of the thousands of people who have contributed to Scrum, we should single out those who were instrumental at the start. Jeff Sutherland worked with Jeff McKenna and John Scamontales, and Ken Schwaber worked with Mike Smith and Chris Martin, and all of them worked together. Many others contributed in the ensuing years, and without their help, Scrum would not be refined as it is today. Scrum Guide History. Ken Schwaber and Jeff Sutherland first co-presented Scrum at the Uppsala Conference in 1995. It essentially documented the learning that Ken and Jeff gained over the previous few years and made public the first formal definition of Scrum. The Scrum Guide documents Scrum as developed, evolved, and sustained for 30-plus years by Jeff Sutherland and Ken Schwaber. Other sources provide patterns, processes, and insights that complement the Scrum framework. These may increase productivity, value, creativity, and satisfaction with the results. The complete history of Scrum is described elsewhere. To honor the first places where it was tried and proven, we recognize Individual Inc., Newspage, Fidelity Investments, and IDX, now GE Medical. Copyright 2020. Ken Schwaber and Jeff Sutherland. This publication is offered for license under the Attribution Share-alike license of Creative Commons. By utilizing the Scrum Guide, you acknowledge and agree that you have read and agreed to be bound by the terms of the Attribution Share-alike license of Creative Commons. Thank you and enjoy.